Hello, my name is Jason Johnson, and thank you for watching these series of videos on the Raptor program. What I'm going to be doing is going through and creating a series of videos that shows you how to use the Raptor program. I have students in an intro to programming course that uses this Raptor program, so I'm creating these videos for them, and I'm putting them on YouTube for anybody else that may need to learn how to work through some of the problems. I use a particular textbook in our university, or at our college, and that's what these are based on. So you can get the Raptor program at raptor.martincarlisle.com. It is a simple way to create programming with flowcharting. And I say simple because it's not super simple, but it helps in the fact that it helps you learn how to create a flowchart of programming, but see it visually. And then you can move over into other programs, whether you're going to go over into C or over into Java or Python or some other type of language. This does not use a language. It uses a flowchart type of way of creating the program. I'm using the Prelude to Programming book textbook. So if you're here from one of the classes that I teach, that's why you're here, most likely watching these videos. If you're somebody else watching these, you can you may be from one of these other courses, or you just may be learning how to use the Raptor program. You can download a copy of the Raptor program at one of these download links here. There's a portable version of it that you can get. If there's a digital signed version, it works on Windows. If you have a Mac or a Linux, you can run maybe a virtual box in that operating system to be able to run the Windows on this as well. So let's get started here. First, when we're looking at the Raptor program, we're looking at the program here. We can go to help and go to about. You can get some general help here. There's some help that you can get if you're needing help with, maybe like math operators and some of the things that are working on here that you would use some of the math operators. You can print. You can do print. You can toggle your ink. So let's save this first, and let's just call this temp.raptor. And you can draw on your workspace area here. You can change the color of your ink. Let's say that you wanted red instead on there. You wanted red. You can do that. You can turn the eraser off if you want to erase things. Just like that. You can turn your ink off altogether. You can change your mode from novice, intermediate, or object oriented. We're going to be using novice in all of these videos. You can do the run, where you can do a step by step of the program. And that way you can use, that symbol right there, step. It's going to step you through each step of the way so you can see exactly, let's say that you're having errors. And a couple of different times I'll show you as we go through how to do that. Or you can just run it all the way through, or you can press pause. You can also cut and paste. You can change your scale. I've got mine set to 150, but see, if you wanted it smaller, you could do that. I'm going to set mine to 150. You can set it up here as well. That's the speed right there that it runs, that the program runs, your play speed. So if you wanted it faster or slower, you can do that. You've got your symbol area here. These where you can drag and drop your symbols onto your workspace area or your work area. So we have our assignment symbol. The assignment symbol is going to allow us to assign some kind of, do some type of processing. You're going to assign or change a value in a variable. You're going to have your call symbol, and the call will allow you to do separate, what I call tabs, but they're subcharts. So let's just call this one sub, and we can create a program here, and let's just say that we're going to put an input here, and then we can have a sub over here. We can have this call, and we can have it call over to sub. And we can put that in there, and then that would actually call over to sub, and it would come over here and execute whatever's in this program and then come back to this program. So, and we'll look at a few of those as we go through. Let's save this again, and I'm going to delete, let me delete that chart. All right. Oh, because I've got a call to it, so it won't let me delete it. There we go. It wouldn't let me delete it as long as I had a call to it. And then we're going to have our area over here, which is our watch area. You'll see things update on your program there. And then we'll have our master console over here. And this will be whenever we're outputting information to the user. It'll also tell us when the program is finished, if we have error codes, things like that. And you can change your font size. I'm going to leave this at 16. Okay, so what we're going to do for an example here is we're going to create a sign-in program. And we're going to create a program. And I've written this out in text form to show us what we're going to be creating here. We're going to ask the user for a first name, then a last name, then a username, then an ID number. So we're going to ask for those four bits of information. Then we're going to create a full name by joining the first and last names with a space between them. Then we're going to create an email address by joining the first and last name with a dot between them. And then we're going to append a domain at the end. In this case, we're going to use jasonejohnson.com. And then we're going to display the results to the user of what we created. So let's create our first program here. It's going to, the first thing that we're going to need to do is create an input for the user. And let's go ahead and save this because I've got this saved as temp. And I'm going to call this one signin.wrap, and it'll be a Raptor file there. And we're going to ask the user for input. So we're going to put an input on the work area, and we're going to double click this here, and we're going to start our input information. We're going to start with quotes, and we're going to say, enter your first name. We're going to do a colon, and we're going to finish with quotes. And then now we're going to create our variable here. And this variable is, we're going to call this one first. We're going to create a variable that is unique to the program. So you're not going to create two first variables because the program will get confused. So we're only going to have one variable called first. You could have called that F name for first name. You could have called it, one name. Whatever variable you create is up to you. Then we're going to create a second input. And this one's going to ask the user for the last name. So we're going to say, enter your last name, colon, quote. And we're going to call this one last. And we're going to see on the program here, we're going to see the quotes that's going to get output to the user. Enter your first name, and then it's going to say get first. So it's going to say whatever was input for first, store that. Whatever was input for last, store that. Then we're going to do an input for username. So we're going to double click that, and we're going to say what is your desired username? Question mark. Quote, and we're going to call this one username. And then we're going to do another input, and now we're going to ask for, and remember what we asked? We said first name, last name, username, and ID. So now we're going to ask for the ID number. So we're going to do quote, and we're going to say, what is your student ID number? Question mark, quote, and we're going to say get, and we're going to call this ID num. IDNUM. We're going to keep it simple. What is your ID number? And now what we're going to do is we're going to do some type of assignment. We're going to do our first set of instructions to the program. We're going to take an assignment symbol, and we're going to put that on the workspace. We're going to double click on that to get that to open up and look at it. And so now we're going to set our variable of full. So we're going to create a variable called full, and we're going to say set the full variable to take what's ever in the first variable, and we're going to say plus, and we're going to say quote, space, quote, and then plus whatever's in the last variable. And let's look at that. It's a little bit larger here. Let's look at this right here. So we're saying first, plus, space, and then we're going to do quotes with a space, space, plus, space, last. So what we're saying is we're asking to take whatever information is in the first variable, add it to whatever is in the last variable, and put those together inside of quotes. So we're going to click done there, and that's going to be an assignment that we've created. And next we're going to do another assignment. We're going to put another assignment on the workspace. We're going to double click that and open that. We're going to say take the first name, put a period in there, then we're going to add the last name, and then we're going to add the jasonejohnson.com. So we're going to take our domain and we're going to add all that in there. So if we take all of this, and I'm going to set that in there, and then I'm going to call this variable email. So I'm going to call this variable email, and then I'm going to say take whatever's in the first variable, put a period there, then take whatever's in the last variable, and then put that on the front of at jasonejohnson.com. And that's our next assignment. Next, we're going to do some output to the user. We're going to take our output and we're going to put that on here. We're going to double click on there and we're going to say output to the user, hello, space, quote, and then we're going to say add whatever's in the username. So whatever is in the username, there we go, username, and add that, and then we're going to put an exclamation mark. So we're going to say whatever's in the username variable, add that, put hello at the front and an exclamation mark at the end. And that'll be an output to the user. And then we're going to do an output to the user, and I'm going to copy and paste some stuff here to make this go a little bit quicker. On the video, we're going to do another output symbol, and we're going to say you entered the following information. So we're going to output that to the user. And then we're going to do another output to the user. And we're going to say on this one, we're going to say your name is, and then whatever is in the full name. So it's going to take what's ever stored in the full variable and output that and say your name is whatever that is. And then we're going to tell the user what their username is. And we're going to say your student ID number. Okay, next we're going to create the student ID. So we're going to put in here a new variable here, and we're going to call this one your student ID number, ID num. We're going to take whatever's in that variable. We're going to click done. And then we're going to do one more output. And this one is going to, and we're going to need to scroll down for this one. This one, and I'm going to put this one here for you, easier to see. You've been assigned an email college address. So we're just going to say, just give this to the user. You've been assigned a college email address. And then we'll put in whatever their email address is. So we'll do one more output, and we're going to say on this output, just give them whatever's in the variable of email. So let's go back up here. Let's look at this in its entirety here. Let's make this a little bit smaller. Ooh, that's way too small there. There we go. So we're entering the first name, the last name, the username, the student ID. We're going to put those together. So we're going to take the first name and last name and create a variable of full. Then we're going to create a variable of email. Then we're going to output to the user all that information. So let's step through this here, and I'm going to bring the master console back up here. And let's step through this to show you how each one of these symbols is going to work. So we're going to start. It's going to start on the start symbol. Then it's going to ask us to put in our first name. We're going to get a prompt after that, and it's going to say, what is your first name? And I'm just going to say Jason. And it's going to ask us what our last name is. And before I do that, look over here on the left-hand side for our watch area, and you're going to see now my first variable is now called Jason. And then it's going to give us that. What is your last name? And I'm going to say Johnson. So now it's stored that variable. Now it's going to ask us what our desired username is, and I'm going to say J Johnson. So it's storing that information, and let's make that a little bit larger. Then it's going to ask us what our student ID number is, and we're going to say, let's just give it a number here of, click OK, so it stores that. Then we're going to say, what is our first, what is our email address? Now this didn't output to the user, it's just going to do it. See, it didn't give anything output to the user, it just took that information, and I'm going to make this a little bit over here. Let me bring this over. And so now it's stored the variable of email as jason.johnson@jasonejohnson.com. And then the next one, it's going to say output to the user, hello, J. Johnson. So see, now I'm a master console. I saw that. Then it's going to say your name, and then you entered the following information. And then the next step is going to say your name of Jason Johnson, your student ID number, and you've been assigned a college email address of, and then it outputs the email address. So jason.johnson.com. So that's the simple sign-in program that you create in Chapter 3 of Prelude to Programming. If you have any problems with that, you can leave a comment below in the YouTube video, and I'll see if I can help you out. I usually get back to YouTube comments within a few days. If you're a student of mine, make sure that you email me from within the class, the program that we use for our classes, and I'll get back with you a little bit quicker than that, usually within 24 hours. Hope this was helpful for you. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.